Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup and welcome to station number 17, where we are going to talk a little bit about the curvatures of the vertebral column. And the example that we have is a little bit off, so we're gonna talk about kind of the specifics in terms of that, knowing that I think the cervical is a little bit curved in this image, a little bit too curved in this image. So recall that when we're talking about the cervical region and the lumbar region, which is going to be right one, two, three, so we're right around this region, we're going to have what is called a lordosis, and it's going to be a bit more concave posteriorly associated with that. So cervical and lumbar region, recall that we are talking that these are going to be lordotic curvatures. Whereas with the thoracic and the sacral, we are going to be more kyphotic in terms of the curvature. So this is the thoracic, and the sacral regions are going to be kyphotic. Oftentimes you hear the term kyphosis or kyphotic, this should be a Y, associated with a pathological condition. And you can certainly have an overcurvature in these regions, but just the normal curvature also have these names. So it would be excessive or extreme lordosis or kyphosis when we're talking about a more pathological condition. Now, recall that these are normal curvatures. I think we have a bit of an abnormality here, maybe just with how it was set up for the image, but the normal curvatures are part of the functional column of the vertebral column, allowing for stability and shock absorption, and not just having one straight line of a column, which would be that would cause other issues in that region. So these are going to be the normal curvatures associated with the cervical and the lumbar, again, are going to be lordotic, whereas the thoracic and the sacral are these primary curvatures, and these will be kyphotic. Okay, thanks for your time and attention here, and I believe we are moving on to the next station and perhaps getting into some of those immovable vertebrae, or we'll save that later for the pelvic region. Thanks for your time and attention here. And have a great rest of your day.